Hello and welcome to video number 4. Let's dive in and we're going to talk about customer only coupon discount. So this is avenue number 1, which we talked about in the previous video. And the whole premise of this video is to actually show you how to implement it within JVZoo.com and how the system works. So let me go ahead and go over to JVZoo.com and show you how to implement this. Okay, so to get here, all you have to do is log into your JVZoo.com account. Under sellers, you want to click that and go to coupons. So if you click that, you're going to get to this page. And all you have to do is simply click on add a coupon, and then you're going to see new coupon. So let me walk you through step by step so you know exactly how to use the different features and all that. So first things first, is going to say funnel. Now, you're not going to click this unless you want to apply the coupon to the whole funnel. So if you're just mainly trying to do it to the front end offer, then you would select the product here and you actually select the product, right? So obviously you will need to know the name of the product to do that, and you just select the product and you're good to go, and then you name it. So if you select the funnel, however, you would have to have the funnel created. And then keep in mind that would apply it to the whole funnel. So you choose the product and then you would name the coupon. So typically what I like to do is I like to name it by either what I'm trying to do. So if it is a private promo, I will do like private promo, the name of the joint venture. And if it's like a generic coupon, like I'll generally name it whatever I'm trying to do. So if I'm scanning through, you're going to have a lot of coupons and you're going to not really going to know what coupon is what coupon. So naming it what you are trying to do, like the strategy or the method involved, usually will help. So you want to try to either do that or you want to create a naming convention of private promo name, right? Or pre-launch coupon for what product, right? And then of course the customer discount is going to be the actual coupon itself. So let me go ahead and do this. Let's say we'll do generic coupon. We'll do, let's say, Thanksgiving 2017 or something. So what you can do here, we can say thanks 17 or something. Or you could do thanks 20 as like $20 off. So the discount, you can either discount it by dollar amount or percent. So if you want to do 50% off, you could just do 50% off. Or the dollar amount, which is, you know, $20 off. So keep in mind that if you do percentage, you need to make sure that the percentage sign is after the number. If you're doing the dollar sign needs to be before the number. But if you just put like 50, nothing's going to happen. You're going to get an error message, and I'll just show it to you right now. If you do 50, click save coupon, it'll actually give you an error and it'll tell you what to do. It says discount must be formatted in dollar sign number or number percent sign. So basically what I told you. So let's say in this case, we're going to do $20 off, and then max usages basically means how many times can this coupon be used. So if you only want to offer it for the first 100 people, you would do 100, right? And you would explicitly need to say that on your sales page. So if it passes, it passes, right? So normally what I do is I do max uses, I'll do 99999. Because that just makes it unlimited. Now you can do a beginning date and an end date. So let's say, for example, like today is October 28th, 2017. And let's say that we want to do it another date. So October, it's almost October, end of October now. So let's do November 1st. And we can also change the actual time over here. Now keep in mind, this is operating on EST in this case. So you're going to want to check EST and the time zone there. So once you're done, you just click on save coupon and that's it.
For more free educational content, Visit learnforfree.biz. Content produced and distributed by AllSuperInfo.